Okay, now it's recording. I was doing all that stuff and crap wasn't even recording. But, okay, so I was going to record this in the house, but it's not going to be quiet because of my grandkids. So, just coming from my, and it's cold as fuck out here. Just coming from my psych appointment today, my counseling, or whatever the hell you want to call it. So, let me give y'all a quick update before the bus comes on school. School went well. For my jazz history, I got a C. And for my sociology, I got an A-, which is really good, which brought my average up to a B. Y'all remember, I'm on academic probation. Because a couple of years ago when I withdrew from school, unofficially withdrew from school, my GPA went into the toilet. The toilet, okay? So, in order to stay in the school, I need to have a 2.0 to get into the sociology program, a psychology program at my college. My GPA needs to be a 2.5. The good thing is that I don't have a lot of accumulating credits, grades and stuff that may hinder that process. So I still have time, to get into the sociology program. I think it's a sociology. You need 40 credits to get in. So I'm nowhere near 40 credits. After January semester, I will have 37.1 credits. So, if I go to school in the summertime, which that's what I plan to do, by time January semester ends, which is May 24th, that following, I'm going to go to summer to take a couple of summer classes, and in that fall, which starts in August, I will be able to get into the sociology program. I hope I didn't confuse y'all. The reason I got a C, I was kind of shocked that I got a C, but not really, because I told y'all my first test, I got like a 20. Yeah. My first test, I got a 20. My second test, I got an 80. My third test, I got a 72. And I'm not sure what I got for my fourth test because that was the last day of class and he didn't post our grades for our last test, but so a C is good, you know, it's something, at least I didn't fail, right? I was so excited that I got an A- on my, in my, sociology class. Miss Murphy is an awesome teacher. I'm looking forward to taking, more of her classes because, as y'all know, my major, everything is mostly going to go around like sociology and psychology. So I'm hoping to take one of her advanced classes. So so I told y'all for January semester, I'm taking a bio, a lab, and then the second stage of my psychology class, which this psychology class focuses on mental health, like schizophrenia, autism, stuff like that. So yeah, I'll be going Monday through Friday. So time to really buckle down, which I have been, but now that I'm going to be going to school more, I don't have as much as leeway as I did this semester that just passed. So everything is going well. We faxed over Ms. Drone because Ms. Drone needs a copy of my bill for January, which y'all, $185, okay? $185 per credit. So I'm taking, I think my bio is three credits. The bio is one and the psychology is four. So, yeah. So my bill is well over $2,000, almost hitting $3,000. So he faxed everything over to the Access program. He faxed her over my bill. He faxed her over my grades for this semester. He faxed her over my schedule for next semester. So we are ready to rock and roll. School starts January 27th, but for me, it starts January 29th because I didn't take any weekend classes. I think that's it. There's really not much to talk about. My daughter's still with me. She must be the most unluckiest person I know, because every time it comes for her to get her apartment, something goes wrong. But she's been here since the day before Thanksgiving, and I'm ready for her to go. I'm telling her, like, every day, like, you asked for 2 weeks. You've been here well over a month. You know, I think I've pulled my share, you know. So it's her and her three kids, and then I told you she's pregnant with another one. So, yeah, it's time for her to leave. I love her to death. I love my grandkids to death, but I'm used to my structure. I'm used to a certain way that I have things done in my house, and I'm used to my mental health being okay. And with her and her kids there, they're driving me crazy, and I'm ready for her to leave. I really am. Like I said, I love her to death, but it's time for her to go. She was at the other grandmother's house, like her youngest child's grandmother. She was there, I think, for more than a month. She asked for 2 weeks there too and stayed longer. So she's here and stayed longer too, but I'm ready for her to leave. So I'm hoping that something pulls through, with this apartment that she just went to look at. And here's my bus. Come on, baby. Here's the bus. All right. Here's our bus. So I'm going to go. But anyway, other than that, everything is good. Yeah. So everything is well. Thank you, everyone, for being so supportive and so kind and so loving. I really appreciate it. And remember to say good morning, good evening, good night to someone with a smile. It'll definitely brighten their day, evening or night. And God bless you all. Say bye-bye. Oh, it says not in service. Son of a gun. Oh, darn it. We freezing out tails. No, but it says not in service. Shoot. Oh, man. Not in service. Anyway, I'm still going to get out of here because my hands are cold. Maybe there's another bus that's coming behind it. Maybe. Maybe that's it. I don't know. Anyway, I'll talk to you all later. God bless you all. Happy holidays. Happy New Year's. And I will talk to you later. Say bye-bye, Junior. Bye.